A man from the state house was quoted today with a cold disposition, neither happy nor gay. Like a tragedy scored with sad violins, he called our fair city a cesspool of sin. He said there once was a time in this forsaken place when a man was a man and a boy knew his place. When the cotton was picked and the shoes were all shined, man of distinction had sweet peace of mind. It was a much simpler time, it was too good to last. But these kids here today have no love for the past. With rings in their noses and tattoos on their skin, they're turning this city into a cesspool of sin. It's a cesspool of sin. It's a bastion of shame. A town that is giving our fair state a bad name. But call us what you will, we'll take it all the chin, saying welcome now entering that cesspool of sin. He concluded his talk and he thanked all the press, but the senator could not possibly guess that we listen politely, yes, and take it in stride, even wear it as a badge of honor and pride. Did we cease and desist? Did we pray and repent? No, the townsfolk embraced it with an ear-to-ear grin, saying, welcome now entering the cesspool of sin. It's a cesspool of sin. It's a bastion of shame. It's a town that is giving our fair state a bad name. Call us what you will, we'll take it on the chin, saying welcome now entering the cesspool of sin. Welcome now entering that cesspool of sin.